So here's the way the debate is being positioned, that it's not about drinking, it's not about the drinking age. It's about the right of choice of the youth. Actor Rajat Barmecha of Udaan fame is joining us tonight on the show. Sohail Seth is joining us from London. We have Pooja Bedi joining us from Mumbai. Purnima Admani, former chairperson of the NCW, is joining us from Mumbai. And BP Singhal of the BJP, former member of parliament and former top cop, is also with us tonight. I want to go to Rajat first, because Rajat, you're the youngest on the panel tonight. And I think you're also, are you under 25, aren't you, Rajat?
Sorry?
You're also under 25.
Yeah, I'm 22.
So how do you view this, Rajat? This whole under 25 ban?
I'm not exactly in the support for this thing. I think 21, which was earlier the age for drinking, I think there was a, I think, decent age. 25 se pehle people, you know, agar aap rakhoge, if you ban people or restrict the youth from doing something, I don't think so kuch bhi rukne wala hai. They still go, they still drink. Bar jao to aapko sab jagah you get booze or you get everything. So agar you know, really, if you want to stop them from drinking, so ye hona chahiye ki if they go somewhere, they don't get, but India mein you go anywhere, you'll get the thing. So I still think that 25 is not you know, right to be the age for people to start drinking. They are much more sensible bahut pehle ki age mein bhi. So I think they're sensible enough to take their own decisions.
I'll take the second view tonight before I go to I want to go to BP Singhal. Mr. Singhal, what is the problem, Mr. Singhal? People can do everything by 21. They can vote, they can get married, they can have a child. It's about freedom of choice, Mr. Singhal.
They are choosing at the age of 16, 17. What are you saying? Where are our bans or our rules or our laws being enforced? Nowhere.
So who decides 25?
There's no point in trying to make it 21 to 25. The question is, we have to ask the young generation, what is it that you have come here to do in this life? Is drinking your sole purpose? You give up your slavehood from your parents, you rebel against them, and you become a slave of liquor. What kind of choice is this? You want to have this kind of a choice?
Aren't you overstating the situation, Mr. Singhal? Aren't you overstating it? Let me get Pooja Bedi in. Pooja?
No, overstating. I'm stating.
Let me get all views in. See, I'm not.
All right. Well, there are a couple of debates.
One
is alcohol good for you and is alcohol bad for you? That's one debate. The second debate is the right for an individual post 21 to choose. Now, when the government decides to enact a law and says this is the age, we're setting a new standard, we're setting a new bar, etc., etc., they enact a new law. Can they keep up to it? Can they enforce it? That's very important. We've had dry states where we see alcohol flowing freely. They talk about illicit alcohol being the cause of all the problems. Illicit alcohol, that means it's not legal anyway. They can't control the fact that illegal alcohol, illicit alcohol is sold, you know, in the smaller towns and in villages. And they expect that they're going to now enforce this new ban. All that's being achieved right now is scope for more corruption, more bribery, and the fact that individuals can drink post 21 in neighboring countries, in neighboring states, but suddenly in this state they become criminals. I think that's absurd.
Okay, I'll come to Sohail last today. I want to go to Purnima Advani here. 30% of white spirits are consumed by people under 25, says the chief executive of the company which makes a popular Indian whiskey. I won't name it tonight. Yes, Purnima Advani. Is someone going to say, I want to drink, but I'm going to wait one more day till my 25th birthday? I'm only 24 right now.
Look, it's not that, Arnav. The issue is that I did hear you saying that, well, you can marry, you can vote, but why can't you drink? The point is, in marriage and in voting, you're calling upon them to exercise their choice to have a positive judgment. Whereas in drinking, you sometimes see that they lose their judgment, they lose their sense of responsibility. All that this law is saying is, it's a message to people to say that, well, wait for a while till your emotional stability is there And alcohol, you would agree, is bad for health, because in many a cases you have liver cirrhosis, you have so many problems that come up from excessive drinking of alcohol. It's okay to laugh, but those who are there at the verge of death in hospitals, in ICU, and please have the response from some parents who are really concerned about their children, young boys, young girls, who have to line up outside de-addiction centers because their emotional instability was there and they over-consumed alcohol. So I think it's a positive move to increase the age, and I think it's more in keeping with health requirements, with the emotional stability requirements. I would say it's a positive move.
Yes. I just want to clarify, ma'am, that wasn't me laughing. That is Sohail, who I think doesn't sound like me. But Sohail,
I've known you for years and years.
Sohail,
so he didn't sound like
you. Sohail was amused by that. Sohail, take the health argument. There's a health argument which is being put. Don't be. Isn't that valid?
This is turning around and saying people are lying on their deathbed in hospitals. They're lying on their deathbed with cancer because of cigarette smoking. Why isn't there cigarette ban? Alcohol at least has some benefits. It has some medicinal benefits. It has some emotional benefits.
Pooja will allow me to.
Cigarettes have no bloody benefits.
Okay, 1 minute. We'll open up the debate. We're opening up the debate.
Cigarettes. Put a lifelong ban on bloody cigarettes.
Now we are opening up the debate in 2 minutes after Sohail. Yes, Sohail.
You know, I find this whole thing pretty bizarre. This Maharashtra government is not bothered about basic infrastructure. There's Adarsh. Now a ship has run ashore. You know, there are serious issues in terms of the underworld. J-Day was shot dead. I mean, these are the clowns who are today running important states in this country. And they're concerned about increasing the drinking age from 21 to 25. Let me demolish B.P. Singhal first and then Purnima Advani's argument. B.P. Singhal says that people rebel against their parents and therefore their set of values, and therefore they shouldn't be allowed to drink. I haven't heard of a more ridiculous argument made by any normal human being for a long, long time such as this. The issue here, Arnob, is as follows. Do you have the capacity to enforce the law should this law come into force? A. B. How will you distinguish unless you ask for identification, which no bars ask?
That's
C. I think the fundamental problem which Purnima talks about is being positive and health and all. It is also what you do and how you're brought up at home. Your family plays a very critical role. I mean, we have seen a lot of rich kids who don't drink, and then there are lots of rich and poor kids who drink and, you know, go berserk. I think the basic issue is, are we saying that everyone who drinks gets drunk and is therefore a threat to people driving or people walking? Or are we saying that when people get drunk, they're a self-threat to their own health? The argument is not about getting drunk. The argument is about choice. Today, you will raise the age from 21 to 25 for drinking. Tomorrow, there may be some issue to do with, consumption of sugar. And you might say that, look, you know, or like what Bloomberg did in New York with trans fats. Now, when you're talking about trans fats, they have been proven to be detrimental in many ways than, you know, a drink. I mean, there are people who have a solitary drink with their dinner or whatever they do. So I don't think this is an argument that holds. I'm genuinely distressed that when we see the kind of things we're seeing in our country, the corruption, the 2G scam, Adarsh, all of these things, we focus on the non-essential issues. I mean, you're allowing people to elect a bunch of jokers at times to state assemblies because they can vote at 18. And then you question their sagacity and wisdom at 25. I mean, I find this whole thing not only deflective, but utterly ridiculous.
So if you have
to have a law, then make sure the law is enforceable.
No, I'll have to balance this. You've made your point very strongly. Mr. Singhal, you heard Sohail's point. I have one question to add from that. You see, in Germany, the legal age for drinking is 16. In Pakistan, it's 21. In UK, it is 18. I'm asking you, is there any statistic to prove that the average Indian matures 9 years, emotionally matures, as Purnima says, 9 years after the average German? or 4 years after the average Pakistani.
I mean,
no. You said you need to be emotionally mature.
I have not said that an average Indian.
I started my statement from this point. In this country, no law can be enforced. So there's no point in making this law of 25 or even today.
Well, that's my point.
16-year-olds are drinking merrily. So there is no enforcement of this. Even the 21-year law, what to say of 25? There I entirely am in agreement that unless you can enforce a law, there's no point in making a law. Number two, yes, if you can enforce it, then the later the person gets addicted to drinking, the better it is. The later he makes a choice,
then change it to 40.
Mature will be the choice.
What, sir?
I'm saying change it to 40. Get rid of the hypocrisy of India. The president of India serves apple juice instead of wine to visiting heads of state. I mean, Jacques Chirac, when he was the president of France, he almost choked thinking he was having some Bordeaux until he realized it was Himalayan apple juice.
That's hypocrisy for you. Serves apple.